Download Storyboard app from Play Store. Learn and prepare for various entrance exams, but with stories. Link for the app is in the description. Now from lines, we move on to our next topic, which is triangles. So let's see what can we study in triangles. First, we'll start studying what are congruent triangles. So I'll ask you a simple question. How do you explain it to a child that two triangles are congruent? Explain it in the simplest possible way, not by any tests. So let me draw two triangles for you. When do you say that this red triangle is congruent to this yellow triangle? When will you say that these two triangles are congruent? Okay, what is the easiest way? Pick up one triangle. Okay, just pick up one triangle and keep it on the other triangle. If they superimpose, do they superimpose? No. Okay, just check it. Does one triangle fits over the other? In this case, red over yellow? No, which means they are not congruent. In congruence, you have SSS test, which means what? All the three sides are equal, which is not happening in this case, which means the two triangles are not congruent. Okay, when will I say they will be congruent? So let's go with this yellow triangle. If I draw a replica of it, this will superimpose on this yellow triangle, which means these two yellow triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, similarly, I can say with rest of the triangles as well. So let's take example of say this again red triangle. I draw a replica of it and I can put this red triangle on the red triangle. So I'll say the two red triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, so simply, how do you say the two triangles are congruent? You can go by tests, which you can find it out, various congruency tests, and simply you can say two triangles are said to be congruent when all the three sides are of same length, okay? Or you can superimpose one triangle on the other, as simple as that. Heard of similarity and similar triangles? So what is the difference now between congruent triangles and similar triangles? How do you say two triangles are similar and two triangles are congruent? Take a triangle, look at it in a magnifying glass. It will increase its side. It will look big, okay? That is when I'll say the two triangles will be similar. What is happening? The small triangle gets amplified. So what is the result of that? Ratio of their sides is same, because you are just seeing an amplified version of the same triangle. So if this is 1, this becomes 10. 1 into 10. This is 5, 5 into 10. This becomes 50. This is 3, 3 into 10. This becomes 30, which means the ratio of their sides, the two triangles. If I say PQR is an amplified version of ABC, PQR and ABC, the ratio of their sides will be same. Okay, let's prove this for our better understanding. So PQ is what? 10. Okay, PQ, AB is amplified as PQ, right? AB is amplified as PQ. So what is PQ upon AB then? PQ upon AB is nothing but 10 upon 1. Okay, so their ratio is 10. Similarly, let's take QR. What is QR? 30. BC is amplified as QR. So what will I say now? QR upon BC. QR upon BC, the amplified upon non-amplified, which is nothing, 30 upon 3, which is again comes out to be 10. I'm proving that the ratio of their sides is coming to be same. Let's take PR. AC is amplified as PR. So what will I do here now? I'll write PR upon AC. PR upon AC is 50 upon 5, right? You can see this PR upon AC, which will again come out to be what? 10. So I proved that one small triangle gets amplified into big triangle. They are called as similar triangles. And what is happening when two triangles are similar? First thing you have to remember, whenever I prove, how will I prove? We'll see it in the next part. But whenever I say two triangles are similar, what will happen? The ratio of their sides, okay, the side which is amplified to the next side, the ratio of their sides will always be same. Not only that, if I take sum of the sides of a triangle, which means say PQ plus QR plus PR divided by AB plus BC plus AC, if I take the ratio of their sides, this will also be same. 50 plus 30 plus 10, 90. 5 plus 3 plus 1, 9. 90 divided by 9, 10 again. Okay, so this is also one result that you can remember. Now let's draw an in-circle inside a triangle. What will happen if two triangles are similar? I draw in-circle. What is an in-circle? A circle which is drawn inside the triangle, touching the three sides of the triangle, will be called as an in-circle. A circle will always have a radius, so let's call this in radius as R1 of smaller triangle and R2 of your larger triangle, which is PQR. This is your in radius, the radius of the circle. So what will happen? R2 upon R1 will also be equal to the ratio of their sides. Okay, so remember that in radius will also be having a ratio. Similarly, I draw a circumcircle that is drawn outside the circle. This will also have its radius because it's a circle. Let R2 be the radius of bigger circle and let R1 be the radius of smaller circle. So R2 upon R1 will always be equal. Big R2 upon big R1. So remember, the result when two triangles are similar, what will happen? Not only that, area of triangle PQR upon area of triangle ABC. If I go ahead and check this, area of triangle PQR upon area of triangle ABC, that will be equal to, take any one side, take PR or QR or PQ, I'm taking one side, PR upon AC. Okay, so PR square upon AC square. This is one result that will also be followed. You know what is PR now? Let's just take it. It's 50. 50 square is 2500. AC is 5. 5 square 25. 2500 divided by 25, 100. So remember that as well. Now we know what will happen when two triangles are similar, but how do you prove? Okay, how do you prove that two triangles are similar? You do it by certain tests. There are many tests. I'll give you just one AAA test, which means I'll prove all three angles of one triangle are equal to all three angles of another triangle. If I prove that, I'll prove that two triangles are similar, then I can write everything which is there as a result for similar triangle.